Welcome to Insurrection Field in Breen, Washington, BS, home of the Cadavers.
The Cadavers? What creative genius came up with that name?
Well, when a team asks the biggest NFL star announcer what he thinks the team should be named, he gives his opinion.
Well, in my opinion, the only name more stupid would be the Commanders.
Today's matchup promises severed limbs and ruined careers. The Tokyo Terminators take on the Breen, Washington Cadavers. Welcome to NFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. It's game day here on the NFL Network, and we are just about to get underway. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow, along with Brickhead Mulligan.
Hi.
Any thoughts on today's game?
Not really. Kind of flatlining right now in the thoughts department. Hey, can you help me get this pencil out of my ear? It's stuck worse than it was the last time.
Yeah, you idiot. And it's first and 10. Second down and a lot. And the quarterback finds his man for the first down. And it's first and 10. And he runs it for 4 yards. Second down and 6. Well, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. And he booted a high arcing rainbow. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a life expectancy of 3 returns. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size, because he just walked all over him. And it's first and 10. He is rolling thunder and, oh, he fumbled that one. Everyone loves being on the highlight reel, leaping over a defender, but sometimes you get hit hard and have the ball knocked loose. He's at the 10.
Touchdown!
Okay, nice and easy, like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
Oh, he just got crushed. It's first and 10. Man, oh man, he hit that line the way you're wife hits the all-you-can-eat buffet at Crab Apple Trees, Bricks.
Ah, you're telling me. She ate 47 Salisbury steaks one time. Thought she had food poisoning. Turns out her lower intestines just exploded.
Oh, that's a relief, because there's nothing worse than food poisoning.
Oh, you're telling me.
That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's first and 10. And he pounds the ball into the defense, picking up 7. Second and 3. And he just nailed the run of the numbers for a touchdown. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, no, Bricks. It means he can return it for... You know what? Never mind. And it's first and 10. Oh, that's a vicious hit. And the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant me.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. Second down in a very lot. And the quarterback calls a sonic blast dirty trick and throws a supersonic. And that is a big gain. You know the defense wants some payback after that. Third and 2. Punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
And he just lets that one go. He says, no thank you, and the defense downs it. And it's first and 10. The ground game should be their bread and butter. A gain of 8 right there.
Anyone seen that Korean kid yet with my barbecue?
Last time I ordered Korean, I got Kim Jong-il.
You've got to catch that. Third and 2. When it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made into dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
Sure. Ain't nothing worse than wasting a good explosive.
Second down and 10. simple game when it comes down to it. I thought the only tie we'd see would be a noose. Instead, they're in a dead heat. Tie game at the end of one. And it's first and ten.
Sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Graham.
A nice run there for 8 yards. Second down and two. The punishing hit. First down and six. And he breaks through for a touchdown. Listen to this crowd. Chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It's good.
Suited and booted, I'm ready for war.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. First and ten. And he'll pick up the first down with a nice piece of running there. And it's first and ten. And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. The coach isn't liking that call. Oh, his head just exploded. They're back up here on first, and they've had enough. The offense jumps on signs and attacks the ref. First down and forever. Great catch for a big gain.
But still not enough for a first. Even I'm frustrated, and I'm a team agnostic.
Second down and more than the QB would like. And the QB might as well just bury himself now because this guy's full on berserk. And the NFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8, the greatest hits of all time.
Huh? Did you just say greatest hits? Where?
Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
First down and six. And he runs into the end zone for a touchdown. He could probably be a better dancer if he went to dance class, but as you can see, he doesn't have the stomach for it. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. And it's first and 10. Second down and a lot. And he pulled out a chainsaw, and now he's slicing and dicing his way through the defense. That gets me every time. Like a jack in the box, Bricks. You never know when one of those hot potatoes is gonna blow. You just crap your pants, Junior. Third down and 9. Nicely done for a first down. And it's first and 10. First down! He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. Bricks, it's the 2-minute warning. You know what that means?
Whiskey?
And it's first and 10. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. They stump the clock with their first timeout, leaving them with 2 in case they need them.
Yeah, just like condoms, hatchets, and wives, huh, Grim?
You know, you just summed up why we don't get together outside of work, Bricks.
And that's a great 9-yard completion there.
Hey, it ain't great if you don't score or move the chains.
And that'll bring up 2nd and 1. Quarterback passes for a touchdown. Man, look at him dance. Looks like someone needs to watch Blade Runner again. And here comes the extra point attempt. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. And it's 1st and 10. Running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe 2.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Except the zombies. They are freaks.
And that'll be 2nd and 8 to go. Third down, and the offense needs a miracle. just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're at.
And the defense uses their second timeout to stop the clock to preserve time for their offense. Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. Most kickers should be able to make this one.
But will this kicker make it? Find out next time on NFL Game Day.
NFL. Well, surprise me. He made it look easy, and he gets 3 points for it. It's a close battle as the quarter ends. Halftime is brought to you by those caring folks at Monsanto Industries. They make the world a better place by making the government tell you it is. We're at the start of the third quarter in a nail biter. The teams line up for the second half kickoff. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and ten. And they run it for a couple of yards. Second and eight to go. First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. Oh, this guy just loves punishing the defenders. That's a first down. And it's first and ten.
What is this, 80s wrestling?
And it's first and ten. And that's how you get your buzz on in the NFL. First down and seven. And he breaks through for a touchdown. Listen to this crowd.
Hey.
Okay, nice and easy like a 2 foot putt.
You miss 2 foot putts all the time, Grim.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And a It's first and ten.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's first and ten. Second down and more than the QB would like. And he just wrestles away. And then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And it's first and ten. It's a punishing hit. Second down in inches. I just made the commentary, but I thought you were supposed to throw the ball forward.
Yeah, you're right. You should.
Third down and a pussy hair. You can tell he's a berserker. Oh, man, what a... Perfect pass, and he scores handily. And they line up for the extra point. Straight through the uprights. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. It's first and ten. And the passing game picking up some steam, a gain of seven there. Second and three. Somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had sewn on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
And it's first and ten.
See this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
And he runs it in for the touchdown.
Suited and booted, I'm ready for war. Put the pedal to the floor. Heavy metal in the background. You should know I don't back down. When it's go time, when it's smoke time, tell them don't cut the cord. And they just get...
Now, this should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stop burrito from Taco Hell.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and, or bloodthirsty, whichever. And it's first and ten. asleep permanently.
You snooze, you lose.
Unless you're in a sleeping contest.
And that'll be second down and four. And that brings us to the end of the third quarter. They'll need to fire on all cylinders to make a comeback in the final quarter. And that'll be second down and four. And he held on to that one for a first down. And it's first and ten. Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a first down. And it's first and ten. And that's how you run the football. A pickup of seven on the play.
Glenn, why is it that more mentally disturbed clowns don't play football? They'd be good.
Yeah, they're all in politics, apparently. If you don't think you can make the interception, batting it down is the next best thing.
Great advice, Grim. That receiver's gonna go far in this league if he listens to you.
I wasn't talking to... Yeah, never mind. Yes, Brick, he will. Oh, great throw! Great catch! And then put 6 points on the board!
The defense could do anything to stop a throw that good, Grim.
You mean aside from bribing the ref, killing the quarterback, or actually playing some D?
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, no, Briggs. It means he can return it for... You know what? Never mind. First and ten. Oh, that gets me every time. Like a jack in the box, Bricks. You never know when one of those hot potatoes is gonna blow. You just crap your pants, Junior. And it's first and ten. Nicely done for a first down. It appears that the ref just received a pair of very expensive alligator skin shoes. They need to put some cement shoes on before this game slips away.
I always wanted a pair of alligator skin shoes, Grim. I heard, though, when you put them on, they feel just like chicken skin shoes.
First down and long, and the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. First down in a mile.
Air ball! Hey, did we start letting ghosts into the NFL, Grim?
No, that was just a shitty pass to absolutely no one. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. Third down and forever. They've called a zap attack. The ball carrier. He took a leap and had the ball knocked out. Fumble.
He's got a case of fumbleitis.
Yeah. don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It's good. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and 10.
So much face. This your first time playing the game? Hey, you with the controller in hand. I'm talking to you.
Second down and 10. And picks up maybe a deuce at most.
Speaking of deuces, I gotta, hey, you got a dollar for the bathroom attendant? He threatened me if I didn't tip him next time.
Sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Graham.
And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was on to the races. Some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuff burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. First and 10. Kind of reminds me of that painting of dead carving the turkey. Grandpa, whole family smiling. He's off to the races. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. The 20. He is running like an old guy looking for a bathroom. First down. And it's first and 10. Oh, what a sack there. I heard this guy likes to play with soft balls. He's going to play with crushed balls from here on out. Second down in a mile. It's the fourth quarter, and we're at the 2-minute warning.
2 minutes until what?
Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. And he just nailed him right on the numbers for a touchdown. Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Straight through the uprights. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Good catch, but not quite good enough at 9 yards. And they stop the clock with their first time out to try and stay in this game.
Oh, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point of the game.
I won't listen to this blasphemy.
If you don't hear it coming, it'll knock you right on your ass. It's caught for the first down. They stop the clock, but they only have one timeout left.
That's okay, Grim. They can have nine.
That's nice, Bricks. But our timeouts are for our sponsors, and we need money more than they do.
Nice pickup for 6 yards. And that's it. That's the last timeout. It's score or die from here out. And that'll be second down and 4. And that'll give them 4 more downs to punish the defense. And you better believe they will. And the offense goes into their 2-minute drill.
Which coincidentally happens to be Brick's match stupsy time.
That's why the girls call me Speedy Gonzalez.
First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. Second down in a very lot. And he throws that one to the sidelines. The kicker should make this, but you know how it goes in this league. Ooh, and that's what they call the money shot. Home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And it's 1st and 10.
When I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the pair.
That's right, folks. It's all tied up, and we are headed to overtime. I don't know how many players are left alive, but the rest are headed to sudden death.
They should call this game Mutant Death League.
Bricks, overtime is a war with some basic rules. The first touchdown wins the game, but if the team that receives the kickoff gets a field goal, then the other team is allowed a possession too. After that, whomever scores wins. Here comes the kickoff. And it's 1st and 10.
Drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's 1st and 10. Knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
2nd down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
In the background, you should know I'll back down.
When it's got time, there's no time to
the Cadavers hold back the insurrection and win today's game. The entire game was trench warfare. Both teams battling back and forth, bruised and battered, but in the end, there could be only one winner.
There are winners in my book. I think that a defeated team should get a participation award because I tried really hard.
Why don't you try real hard to shut the fuck up?
Nice mouth. Why don't you try to lay off the scotch, Junior?
Suck on it.
Real nice. Let's go to the game's MVP. Once again, the folks at Evil SN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzro with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the Micro Heart Corporation. They get it right